Hello friend, welcome to my channel 5 Minute Pediatric. Today I will approach to glycogen storage disease. So questions are frequently asked from glycogen storage disease. So we have two forms, hepatic form and other is muscular form. So let's discuss hepatic form. So hepatic form usually present with hypoglycemia and hepatomegaly. Okay. So if a child with hypoglycemia and hepatomegaly, then we should think of GST. So if it is present, okay, then try to correct hypoglycemia by giving IV epinephrine or glucagon if it is not corrected or no effect. Okay. Then think of type 1 GST, what we call von Gehrke disease. Okay, some typical feature of von Gehrke disease that it has doll-like facies, short stature. Okay, it has unique feature of rhinomegaly also. So question are frequently asked in which condition rhinomegaly is common, that we have type 1 GST. Then other feature we have 4P, so that you can easily remember, it has platelet defect due to which it present with epistaxis or easy bruising. Okay. Other P we have plasma looks like milky. Okay. Why it happens to say there increased triglyceride level. There is increased risk of pancreatitis. This is triglyceride also responsible for this. And there is pulmonary hypertension. All these are typical feature of type 1 GST. And it is corrected by or treated by continuous infusion of dextrose or glucose or uncooked starch. Okay. Enzyme what we have, glucose 6-phosphatase deficiency. This is about the type 1 GST. Question frequently asked. Now next what we have, if you give and if get blood glucose gets corrected, okay, then next step what we have, we look for glycogen structure. If glycogen structure is normal, then what we have, type 6 GST, what we call HERS. Here is hepatic phosphorylase deficiency. Okay, and if it is abnormal, so we have CORI, type 3. Here C after D, we have debranching enzyme. C, CORI, we have debranching enzyme and their limit dextran. Just remember all the point, you can solve all the question, okay? Now next what we have, if the child is not having hypoglycemia or hepatomegaly, still we have one type 4 GST, what we call Anderson. It usually present with cirrhosis, so they initially there is hepatomegaly, but it usually present with cirrhosis, and then there is hypoglycemia, usually no hypoglycemia also. No hypoglycemia, no hepatomegaly is due to cirrhosis. Okay. Now next, what we have, muscle form. Muscle form usually present with muscular cramp or with easy fatigability, exercise intolerance, okay, myoglobinuria, urine became burgundy color. All this, if you have all these features in the question, then think of McArdle. And type 7, what we have taught is, okay, McArdle is 5th, there is a muscle phosphorylase deficiency. Okay, this is, and one we have typical, what we call Pompe's disease, 100 times question are asked. So I have made mnemonics for this, and if you remember all this point, you can solve the question. So here we have A for autosomal recessive condition, B for biopsy. When we go for muscular biopsy, we get vacuole that stain positive for glycogen. Okay. Here we have massive cardiomegaly, and defect we have acid maltase. Okay, this question is also frequently asked. Enzyme replacement therapy is available for this condition. Now we have ECG. There is high voltage QRS complex. Okay, with short PR. PR gets short, PR interval. This question, you will get hint. Question, you will get hint in the form of a child having high voltage QRS with short PR interval with cardiomegaly. So what was the diagnosis? So this is Pompe's disease. If we go for echo, you can have biventricular thickening. And it has typical facies. It has coarse facies. Okay, there is hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Okay, all these points are important. So hope you enjoyed this video. Kindly like, subscribe and follow my channel. I am available on Facebook and YouTube. Thanks for watching.